Let's talk about our bowling pins. There are many varieties. I'm using an E-pin on here. And you can see this nice straight seam along the side. This is a good start to give yourself a nice straight edge. I'm using a Sharpie here so you can get a better view of it. And line out on the about halfway down the pin for the front part of the mouth. And what we're going to do is make this sort of a graceful, gradual curve back to the center of the pin on the underside, you can see here. And what you want to do is just sort of eyeball it and make a good, graceful curve. You can look at the scrapbook tapes. There's some great side shots of Crow in there. And just continue your line around. Look at it from the front to make sure you're straight and level across there. And then flip it around. You want to take that little section out of the back. Same idea. Use the seam to get a good straight edge. And then make an ellipse that connects with the other straight edge on the other side. Now the tough part with this is cutting this stuff out. It's pretty thick, and in this case it takes a little bit of sawing to get. I use a coping saw here. I've got the pin locked in a vise with a towel to keep it from marring. Coping saw on the back here to cut through this thick, heavy plastic, and a straight hobby saw here on the front. I use one side first and then go to the other. Try to connect across the middle so it's a nice straight line. And then to cut the curve, I'm using more of a flexible hobby saw too, and just cut the curve around the back completely through. Now all these parts need to be sanded, but here take a look at a side view of where the connector is going to go into Crow, and the 2-inch piece of half-inch PVC coming out the top. I use a 1-inch keyhole saw to make the hole in the bottom. Works really well, pretty clean. You're going to need an X-Acto to maybe scrape out any of the loose plastic. And then you'll see how this straight half-inch PVC connector fits right inside the neck. And I do the same on the top with a half-inch hole saw and put in a 1.5-inch, 2-inch piece of half-inch PVC. I've got some putty around the edge here to help clean it up. You can see how that seems to help it a lot. And here's how the soap dish will eventually fit on top. Nice and clean. You can see where it fits. Anyway, these pieces need sanded. All the edges need cleaned up pretty well. This is 320 grit. I do the whole surface and all the edges. Helps the paint take later. Now I'm going to drill 2 1/8-inch holes in the side of essentially Crow's head, and I'm going to do 2 matching holes on what would be Crow's mouth. And they're 1/8-inch. This is where the pop rivets are going to go later to hold this elastic and plastic thing together. Okay, you can see now we're going to do some much smaller holes. We're going to add 1/16-inch holes, 3 of them. 2 side by side, and those are going to be for the elastic loop of string that goes from the top piece to the bottom piece, and 1 a little lower and in the center for the mouth control string. That's how they look. And of course, 2 more on top at the very bottom edge of the E emblem on top of the pin. And you can see by this photo here what will happen with the string. Okay, let's take some O30 styrene plastic, some scrap you have lying around. And we're going to take a piece of it 2¼-inch wide and make a mark on the where the pin meets up to it, and also a mark on the inside of the head. Here we're marking 2 corresponding holes to show where we're going to drill. These are going to be like braces that hold the elastic in. Here's our elastic strip. And what we need to do is sort of scratch up the surface so that the hot glue holds better in here. And here's our old friend. That's right, hot glue. Going to put this to the inside back of the headpiece, and we're going to use pop rivets. If you haven't used them before, they're great. As you pull on this tool, it flattens out the rivet and cuts the center post at the same time. Okay, I'm going to put a little more hot glue on here. Glue this to the inside of the pin, the head part, and it's going to follow the curve of the pin. And then we're going to drill a couple of holes through this plastic and elastic and put our pop rivets in. Here you can see it's in there. All right, we're going to shove the pop rivet through and squeeze 3 or 4 times until it actually snaps off the center post. and leaves this great little mechanical fastener that doesn't fail like some glues do. Okay, we're going to repeat this over and over, both sides on the back and both sides on the mouth part, the loose flapping part. All right, more hot glue. Match up the cutout piece of the pin. You want it to overlap a little bit and repeat the same procedure, basically. Plastic, then pop rivets. And until you can see here, after it's been primed, put all four pop rivets in place, holding the elastic in. And what I'll do is finally put one more solid piece of the same elastic with some hot glue across the center of the mouth to hold it in place. And to cover the pop rivets and to reinforce the hinge. Works pretty well. All right, here's the elastic string we're going to use to push through some of those holes we've made. Make a loop with it on the bottom. Start with one. I'm using a straightened out paper clip here to help shove these through. Put the other piece through. We're going to pull these through to the center. You can see it will make a sort of a loop on the back here. That's what holds it in place. And on the top, on the E emblem, we're pushing both pieces down through there as well. Takes a little bit of patience. And then reach through, grab both loose ends, and tie a nice, fairly tight. If it's too tight, the mouth won't open. If it's too loose, it hangs open. But tie a nice square knot here. And I usually reinforce that with a tiny dab of hot glue. And trim off the loose ends. Here's the string in the bottom, just a little knot, works pretty well. Dab of hot glue also. A good friend of mine, Joe Crow, uses this method on his crows. He leaves a half inch or a 3/4 inch piece of the pin that serves as the hinge. You just don't cut all the way through and it keeps it perfectly in place. The only problem I've had with this is my paint tends to crack right there. So here's a final primed, ready to be painted. Crowhead. Here it is with a couple of good coats of the nice glossy gold on there. Looks pretty good. And then I also touch up any loose areas, open areas that have gotten overspray with some flat black paint and a square paintbrush. Just take your time. You know, a lot of people don't even see that, but we'll take a look now to the soap dish. This is what the vacuum formed piece of O60 plastic looks like after it's pulled out of the vacuum form machine and cut off the big sheet. I'm using a pencil held at a 90 degree angle, and I run this around the soap dish to give me a line to cut from. Good firm cut with a X-Acto knife, slightly dull helps, but follow it all the way around, and this will actually score pretty easily, and then you just snap off the piece all the way around. You still need to sand a little and scrape some of the loose edges, but it works pretty well, actually getting a good first cut. I'm going to do the same thing with the pencil, trace out the line around the inside opening for the eyes, and take my time a little bit more carefully with this. You don't want to cut into the top or bottom plastic and ruin the soap dish. Same thing though, take 3 or 4 passes with each cut. Takes a little while, but eventually then you can just press through at the ends. And the same method for opening this up works here too. Just keep pressing until you get an opening, and then you can pull this right out. I like to use a couple of different grades of sandpaper, 180, 220, to smooth this stuff down. I'm going to use a 3/4 inch drill bit here to make an opening in the bottom of Crow's soap dish. Very carefully cut that out. You can see how that slides directly. Clean it up a little bit. It should slide directly over the piece of half-inch PVC that we've left on the top of Crow's bowling pin. There it is. All right, let's finish up the soap dish. We're going to take another scrap piece of plastic and trace out the shape of the back. Cut that out. And to secure it, I use these wall anchors and a little of our old friend hot glue. Put these wall anchors in so that they're flush with where the back goes on. And there's going to be a couple of gold screws back there. So here we're using some hot glue inside the painted soap dish. I'm going to apply one more of the wall anchors. And I put the top on to make sure that it's flush and it doesn't stick out beyond. You can see it in there. And then once these are dry, oh look, more hot glue. Yay. Once these are dry, we're going to set them back inverted on top of the back piece that you've cut out. Trace around these, and then that'll help me figure out where the center of them is so I can drill a hole. Using a sharp pencil, holding the back in place, trace around these, and you'll see there they are. I'm just going to drill a hole in the center of each of these. Here's a finished crow with the back plate going on, you can see. Touch up with black paint on the inside. Now for the arms and hands. Here's the 3/8 plastic stock that's been painted. Here's some of the resin elbow parts. Completed arm. The arms are 9.5 and 10.5 inch plastic. The foam is 8.25 and 9.25. This is a resin hand. And here's the plastic I use. Plastruck 3/8 inch stock and 1/4 inch. I don't use the 1/4 inch anymore. It's too small, so I just use 3/8. Mark out your pieces. Use a chop saw or whatever you have to get a good clean straight line across here. Be sure and spray all your bolts and odds and ends. It's nice to have them look good when you put the entire thing together. And just assemble it like you've seen from the photos in the scrapbook or from Crow. Just piece by piece, and I'll take your time. And then this, here's the original Crow hand, the grabber hand from the fair. You can find those fairly regularly now. And looks pretty good painted. And here's the cast resin hand. Anyway, when it's done, hang it on the post that sticks out of the old shoulder that you've already installed. Slide the rubber tubing down, and Crow's looking pretty good now, getting nearly complete. Okay, I want to work on the mouth control rod right now. It's all based on 6.5-inch long piece of a 1/2-inch PVC with a 1/2-inch connector at top. I've taken a 1/2-inch drill bit, drilled 2 holes, and then connected them in the middle, cut them open. And you can see I've also drilled a small 1/8-inch hole for where the string will come out later. This is the opening that you're going to be able to control Crow's eye movement with. You're going to see I'm using a 1/2-inch diameter piece of plastic tubing. It's going to be 31.5 inches long, and that's what slides down the inner throat of a Crow. All right, here it is. You'll see it painted closer to the end, and there's also a small hole drilled in the bottom for a pop rivet, and that'll keep that piece from sliding out. All right, here it is again. We're going to slide this up the throat of Crow, the inner esophageal chamber, if you will. This also has the connector on the bottom. It's going to hold the weight of the puppet on top of it and allow the head to spin 360 degrees freely inside. So this is 23 inches long, and it slides up inside the neck. And here's what comes out on the top. You can see I've also drilled another hole for the string. Here's that C-clamp we made. I'm going to use a little super glue around the neck. Push this down onto the top of the body. Don't get any glue on the body, but make sure it's tight but still spins freely, and you can see the hole for the string in there. All right, now we're going to feed the string through the rubber tubing and back through the body. I put a small hole in this rubber tubing to allow the control string to go through. All right, as you can see, I've fed it through the small hole, and we're going to then push the string back down inside the neck. It's going to go all the way down the body, essentially, down to where the handle is. I use a bent paper clip here to pull that string, fish it out, and pull that string out. Now you can put that completed mouth and neck and head that you already have. Put it firmly on there. Make sure it's lined up with the string. Stick it on there, and you can see it works pretty well. Pull the string, the mouth opens. The rod also allows everything to spin freely. We're going to work on the eyes a little bit right now. Of course, we know they're ping pong balls. The originals were Gnip Gnop balls, Joel said, but ping pong balls are easier. I match up the logos just so those are out of the way. But first, I like to cut an opening because I'm going to put a small 3/4 inch long number 6 machine screw. Glue it on with some hot glue at a 90 degree angle to the ball. Hot glue. And place it on there. I'm going to put a little more hot glue on top of it to keep it in place and also secure the ball on top of it. It's got a little notch cut out of it as well. Logo to logo. And squeeze that into place. Now we're going to paint these. Once it's dry, I use a nice set of vice grips. And again, a little more hot glue to make sure it's in place. You don't want any on the front, just on the back so you can't see it. Vice grips, and I'm using the safety yellow Krylon spray, a couple of coats of that, and then I go back over that with the fluorescent yellow. Makes it nice and flat. All right, let's cut out some eyeballs. I'm using electrical tape. I have a nice self-healing cutting mat right here. I line this up so it's got a good straight edge. Use the other straight edge that's 90 degrees to it. I'm going to triangle cut it out. Each of the crow's pupils are supposed to be 5/8 of an inch square. So we use a ruler and measure these things off. Cut the strip so it's 5/8 inch tall this way. Mark at 5/8 inch here. And when you cut these out, you have two perfect squares. And this particular board makes it easy to peel up these pieces too. Save them to put on his eyes. Okay, we do that twice. Make sure they're nice and straight. And you can put the pupils on now, or you can put them on when Crow is finished. I found it just as easy to go ahead and put them on now. So you can peel it up. You might even want to use your X-Acto on the edge to help lay it on and find the center. And once you get one centered, it's a little bit easier to get the other one. But you take your time. Press from the middle out. And that removes any bubbles. You don't want to trap any bubbles underneath here. Start in the middle and push your way out. And then match up the points, you know, corner to corner. Make sure they're straight and level and equal. Otherwise, it's really easy to make Crow look cross-eyed very quickly. So match those two points up. Press from the middle out. Remove any air bubbles. And this works really, really well. And now let's work on the actual control rod that works those eyes. These are all different kinds of wheels that I've used in the past to try to find the best one for Crow. This is from a screen door roller. It's not bad. One I ended up using was from a Lego set. I cut off the little bumps, made a master mold for it, and I cast these out of resin. And these work quite well. I can make as many as I need that way. First off, let's cut two slices about a half inch deep, 3/4 inch deep in that half inch plastic rod using a straight hobby saw. This piece, remember, is about 3/4 inch deep. Use a pair of needle nose to bend this back and forth and back and forth until that snaps out. And then with an X-Acto, we're going to clean these edges up just a little and run some 150, 200 sandpaper through here too to smooth down, make sure there's no sharp, hard edges. Using the X-Acto knife here to clean up. Again, be careful. Try to make it a nice, straight, clean cut. And here's the sandpaper to make sure it's smooth. Okay, back and forth. Now I'm taking an 1/8 inch drill bit, and I'm going right across the top, maybe 1/4 inch down from the top. And this is a nice, straight, parallel shot. And here's some plastic model scrap. They call it sprue. You can see the hole. You can see I've drilled a matching hole through the wheel. And the plastic goes through here. This is a great way that I found to mount this. Is very carefully, kids, get your mom and dad's help. Light this plastic, blow it out, and while it's still hot, use something flat like a tool here to press this down and get this nice flat. It makes like a rivet, basically, holds this in place. Now I'm going to flip this around, do the same thing to the other side, and it's a great fastener. No screws needed. It spins freely inside. I've also drilled a corresponding hole for the eyes in here. You can see I'm screwing them in to make sure they fit. Okay, here's a diagram of the mouth control rod and the inner control rod for the eye movement. It's a 1/2 inch tube, and you can see where it fits. There's the other wheel on the bottom, and a small stick that controls the eyes up and down and left and right. There's a small notch where a pop rivet will go, and this holds this whole mechanism in place and keeps it from sliding up and down in the neck. A little piece of the same plastic that works as a sort of a stop to keep this from falling down Crow's neck. So feed the nylon string in here. Usually I use a black string, but I wanted you to be able to see this. Feed it all the way down to the other end. You're going to pull that tight. And down on the other end of your wheel, you're going to tie a knot. Again, a square knot works best. And tie this pretty pretty taunt, so that there is definitely tension going down that inner tube. Pull pretty tight. You don't want to pull too tight or the tube flexes, but pull it as tight as you feel, and then go ahead and make a nice square knot. I'm going to put a dab of hot glue or modeling glue on here so this doesn't come undone. And essentially this knot will be pulled back inside. This nylon string you want to actually cut with a match. Sort of sears the edges together so they don't unravel and run. All right, and this is going to be shoved up inside so you don't even really see the knot ever again. Sort of use your hands and press it in there. You can see the eyes, they're being screwed into the corresponding hole. You screw till it's tight. When you move your wheel, the eyes go up and down. All right, here's my inner mechanism that's been painted black. You don't need to paint the whole thing because you don't see it all. And here's the other end that's going to go down the throat. You can see I've done the same thing in here. And here's the little trigger that I make. It's a piece of dowel rod with a rubber cover on the end and a piece of heavy-duty hanger that I've cut. All right, this little hole, this edge matches up to this little hole where I put a pop rivet. This keeps this piece from sliding out. You can see there's the hole for the pop rivet. There's the little ridge I've cut. Make sure there's enough room to go back and forth. But that keeps this in place here. Back and forth. It spins freely inside. And here's the wooden dowel that I've cut and shaved down, painted black. I have a hole in the bottom here. And here's my piece of hanger, nice and straight. And this will go down into the wheel. I use some glue in here. Here's the dowel rod. It's just a, I think it's a 3/8 of an inch. Okay, I'm pressing the hanger down in here with some glue. Gonna put some glue inside here too. Maybe some modeling glue or hot glue or even super glue. And you can see by pressing this up and down, it moves the eyes up and down. Turning it left and right also moves the eyes left and right. Once I put the pop rivet in place, it will keep this from sliding up and down, though. Here's a little screw that I put in here to show you. The pop rivet works best. But this allows it to go left and right and not come out. And now we're going to attach the soap dish. Here's our wheel. Here's the painted soap dish sliding over the top of the wheel and a crow's half-inch piece of PVC here. You want to make sure it's centered. And when it is, when you're happy with it, get out your old buddy hot glue here. Yay, hot glue. And no one's going to see this again, so fill this in and make sure it really holds this soap dish in place. Okay, you can see this is working pretty well. And another dab of the hot glue on top that holds the string in place, keeps it from sliding. See, the eyes have to have room to spin freely inside. And forth. And here goes our back panel. It's going to be secured with 3 gold screws. And those go into the wall anchors that we glued into place earlier. I like to use these gold anodized screws, or you can also spray paint the screw. You're going to put all 3 in here. This makes it easy to get to the back of Crow's eye mechanism if something ever goes wrong. It's better than gluing it on and making it so you can't get to it later. So all 3 screws go in here, and we want to make sure that the eyes spin freely, that they don't scrape the top or the bottom. Sometimes you might have to shorten the screw that holds Crow's eye onto the wheel. It's all about final minor adjustments to make it work and look good. And you'll do the 3rd screw, but you get the idea. I'm going to spin him around, take a look. Make sure the eyes go left and right, up and down. And again, you don't want them scraping against the inside of the soap dish. There we go. Okay, now we do want to put the final touch on Crow here, and that's going to be the Cooper XL7FG mask on the back. Yours will already be primed and painted. Lots of coats, nice and shiny. All right, you want to find the center of this mask at the bottom. Count between the grids of the mask openings and find the center. and you want to do a dry fit on the back of Crow, look from the side, look at the scrapbook tapes. Again, once this is on here, you're not going to want to move it. You're not going to want to drill more than one hole. It has to be done right the first time. So look from the front, look from the top and the back, and find what appears to be a center. I mark it with a Sharpie, both on the pin and the mask itself. Here's a 1/4-inch drill bit we're going through. Very carefully, you got to be careful, the paint will chip. And we're doing a matching hole here in the mask. And we're going to use a nut and a wing nut with a couple of washers. These washers have been painted the lime gold. So again, these are the details that make Crow look really good in the end. You know, your bolts match and everything looks really good. All right, so here's a big washer and that 1/4-inch, it's about a 1/2-inch long screw. And we're going to come up from the bottom with another washer and a wing nut. You can use a regular nut too if you like. I've gone ahead and painted these black because the underside is black as well. So hold those in place, reach up, start tightening down the mask. You want it to be in there pretty good. The nice thing about this is if you ever pack Crow up for shipping or to mail, you want to be able to take that mask off. It's just easier to pack him up. And here's a photo, a still photo you can look at of both the top and underside of a completed Crow. This hasn't been painted, so you can see it a little bit better. And so finally, here's our finished Crow. Pretty amazing, really, feat of mechanics. Eyes move up and down, left and right. The head spins a full 360 degrees freely. The mouth works. Pull the string. And it was a bit more complicated than servo, but certainly worth it. I think you'll be proud to have this guy sitting around. So good luck with yours, and let me know if you have any other questions. And thanks for listening.
Just ram that moldy olive loaf into your loser face.
Can't believe I have to wash Satan's towels.
I'm worried that my sandwich may be small and inadequate.
Now, I'm confused. Am I Chocolate Jones or Sugarfly McQueen?
You're both. And you're also reading the part of Sweet Mama Stringbean, who runs the Boutique de Beauté.
This is a story of a robot named Crow. Can you guess what Crow is thinking? Crow is thinking hard, or as hard as he can think, anyway, on how the satellite got so darn clean. It wasn't clean this morning. Think hard now, Crow. Think really hard, you poor dope. Scan that scrap heap you call a brain and try to find some piteous shred of thought.
Hey, knock it off.
Yeah, keep on trucking, I guess. I guess you'll do your thing and I'll do mine. Yep, whip inflation now. Bye.